The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Since it was preparation day, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for the Sabbath day of that week was a solemn one, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and they be laid taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first, then of the other one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. An eyewitness has testified, and his testimony is true. He knows that he is speaking the truth, so that you also may come to believe. For this happened so that the scripture passage might be fulfilled. Not a bone of it will be broken. And again another passage says, they will look upon him whom they have pierced. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Early years in my priesthood, I was taught by Bishop Sok regarding conflicts among priests. And he said, if you are falsely accused and you have proven yourselves that you are innocent, you have the right to rejoice. Pag napatunayan mo na wala ka talagang kasalanan, may karapatan kang magsaya. But the punchline was, pero pag napatunayan mo ang kapatid mong pari ay nagkamali, wala kang dahilan para magsaya. If you have proven yourself right, then you have reasons to rejoice. But if you have proven anybody, your wife, your siblings, your children, your parents, anybody, that they are wrong, you have no reason to rejoice. Why? Because love never rejoices in evil. Love never rejoices in evil. We have this bad habit of putting people down as if when we put people down, we are raising ourselves better than them. It never happened. It never happened. Knowing the sins of others does not make you holy. Do not forget that. Knowing the sins of others does not make you holy. Talking about their sins makes you more sinful. That is gossip. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, do not forget this. That the Sacred Heart loves us not because we are right and good. Even in the very beginning, before we were born, the first reading says, we are already loved by God. As many times I have said this, there is nothing you can do to make God love you more. And there is nothing you can do to make God love you less. Because the love of God never changes. Never changes. Did God find joy in proving that we are sinful? God need not to do it. Alam ng Diyos at alam natin na tayo makasalanan. We have our own skeletons in our own closet. We know that. there are things we are so afraid that people might know about us. That's why when we try to boast and brag about ourselves, it is indicative that we are hiding something. Inuulit ko, when we tend to brag and boast about ourselves, it is indicative that we are hiding something. Walang nalilihim sa harapan ng Diyos. At alam ng Diyos na mayroon tayong pagkakamali at pagkukulang. And that makes the Sacred Heart different. Teresa of Avila would always stress that. Cardinal Chito Tagle was even able to compose a song about it. Pintig ng puso. I do not know if you have heard the song. Musmus ka pa lamang, minahal na kita, mula sa kawalan, tinuring kang anak. Sa bawat tawag ko, ika'y lumalayo. Hindi mo babatid, ako'y nabibigo. As if we run away from God, we can really survive. As if in denying God, we can live. The second reading reminds us of what? There is nothing you can boast except the love of God. There is nothing. Is there anything you can say you have done that you are worthy of the love of God? Raise your hands. Raise your hands. Is there anything you have done that you can really say, I deserve the love of God? No one, nothing. Ano sabi ni Saint Augustine? Ako ay parang isang dumi sa kuko ng aking hinlalaki sa paa, ngunit minahal mo ako sa gitna ng aking kadustahan. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, to be human is to be taken from the clay, mula sa putik hiningahan at ikaw ay naging tao. Kaya nga ang pagkatawang tao ng Diyos ay ano? Niyapos niya ang putik ng pagiging tao. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? Para lang maintindihan mo kung gano'ng kakamahal ng Diyos, siya'y naging putik para maging tao. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, ano sabi sa mga nakalipas na araw? If you deny Him, then He will deny you. But if you will be unfaithful, God will remain faithful because He cannot deny Himself. That is the Sacred Heart. And what is the gospel trying to tell us? A Sacred Heart is a heart that willing to suffer. A Sacred Heart is a heart willing to suffer. Alam niyo, madaling magmahal kapag nasusuklian ang pagmamahal. Sabi ko nga minsan, nag-anoint ako ng matanda, 10 taon na nakahiga. At nung pagkatapos kong in-anoint, sabi ko, Nanay, 80 years old. Anong gusto niyo pa-birthday sa inyo ni Jesus? Ano sabi niya? Sana bigyan pa ako ni Lord ng another 10 years. Sabi ko sa kanya, hindi kayo napapagod humiga. 10 taon na kayo nakahiga. Hindi, Father. Alam kong love ako ni Lord. Tapos sabi ng caregiver, di ko na kaya. Di ba, ano? Hindi ko na kaya. Love is measured when you love and not being compensated. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, again, if you remember the words of Saint Thomas, unless I put the hands on his side and put my finger on his hands, I will not believe. But during the crucifixions, the only apostles that was present was John. The rest ran away. How did he know that there was a wound in the side? How did he know? Because they have witnessed it. The one who made it witness and proclaim it. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, perhaps a good question that I would like to think you about is, what is the proof that you can really say, I know I was loved by God. I know I was loved by God. Do you know that it is so difficult to be loved by God? People are so afraid to be loved by God. Why? Because they are so afraid that God might ask something from them. Ask yourself, or a story, or an occasion that you can really say, alam ko, mahal ako ng Diyos. Alam ako. Kung wala kang kwento, sorry, wala kang kwenta. Yan ang katotohanan. Kung wala kang kwento, wala kang kwenta. We are so afraid to be loved by God because we are so afraid that what we have might be being asked by God to be taken away from us. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, sana magsimula tayo sa pamilya, no? Rather than lambasting our fellow siblings about their wrongs, their mistakes, rather than talking about the evil people are doing, why not look into ourselves? As many times I have said this, if you see good people, emulate them. But if you see bad people, examine yourself. Again, if you see good people, emulate them. Try to become a better person. But if you see bad people, never judge them. But try to examine yourself. In knowing your sins, the more you will understand the Sacred Heart. That before I was born, I was loved. And in my sin, I am being loved. And when I die, I will die with the love of God. Amen. I do not know if you have heard this. A priest in the United States was sued by biting the hands of a mass goer. Kinagat niya yung kamay nung nagsisimba. And in the court, the judge asked, is this true, Father? And the priest said, yes, I did it. And sabi ng judge, so why did you do it? Ang sabi niya, because the woman suddenly reached his hands to the ciborium during the communion. She was desecrating the sacrament. for her to let go, I beat her hands. And when the woman was asked, why did you do it? And the woman said, I just want a piece of the cookie. I just want to have a piece of the cookie. My dear friends, we are not receiving cookies in the mass. Do not forget that. Katatapos lang ng pagdiriwang ng Corpus Christi, we believe in the real presence. This is Jesus. As many scientific examination has done in the many, many Eucharistic miracle, it is the same. The part taken from the corpus is from the muscle of the heart, and the body and the blood is type AB. Consistent. Anyway, going back to what I've said, someone asked, Father, I'm old and I cannot memorize the prayer anymore. I cannot remember the prayers anymore. Can you advise a short prayer that I can recite? A mantra that I've been saying through the years is, Jesus, Son of the Living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Jesus, Son of the Living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. It would be enough. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you in your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.